The Fast and Furious films have become one of the biggest movie franchises in the world, and it all began in the streets of LA in 2001.
Everything traces back to the original The Fast and the Furious, this 20-year-old sort of street culture movie that wasn't supposed to become as huge as it has now become.
Sean O'Connell, managing editor at Cinema Blend, helps us celebrate The Fast and the Furious with a look back at some of the best of what it had to offer just in time for its 20th anniversary.
Whether it be cast chemistry or just the use of cars and the sort of attitude that that first movie gave to the idea of the franchise, it's still carrying it 20 years later. And anytime a franchise is able to do that, that's super impressive.
Our list begins with a look back at what inspired the action-packed flick.
Let's go for a little ride.
Director Rob Cohen took inspiration from a 1998 Vibe magazine article about illegal street racing in New York to make the film.
Fast and Furious sort of showed this culture and tapped into this area where people were going out and racing these cars and sometimes through the streets. It's not like it was a completely original concept, but I don't think that it was done with this level of attitude.
What's it gonna be?
An approach that worked because it made the film a box office success, grossing over $207 million worldwide.
I think that was completely unexpected for Universal. They didn't have major stars in it at the time. They kept the budget relatively low, but it landed at the perfect time.
Winning's winning.
Yeah! The practical element of it, the community aspect of it, the Los Angelesness of it just connected with the audience and sort of powered it through for several weeks into its opening.
And in the end, gave fans from around the world the need for speed.
Let's go!
It all started with the film's first racing scene, which would set the tone for what would come in the future.
It went out of its way to root most of its action set pieces in car stunts. You didn't go and get like a digital explosion of obviously bad CGI.
Something that helped people connect with the film even more.
People come out of the theaters and they get into their cars and there's just something really primal about revving up your engine and making you feel like you could be that person on screen. But when you get behind the wheel of a car after you've just seen a Fast and the Furious, that steering wheel feels different.
Showing off the best of the Fast and the Furious.
See ya.
On the Hot List.